Hello and welcome, everybody, to another episode of Holding It Down with Three Plate Tommy. We're right here with a cool show. We got the wonderful, nostalgic Latino with us today. He's going to be sharing some stories about everything and letting you guys know what's up with everything he's doing and what's happening right now. But thank you for coming out here and you know, I know it was a drive. You said it was a mean-ass drive over here.
Bro, it was a mean-ass drive.
Yeah.
And so this podcast better be worth it, fool. You know,
hey, dog. Hey, homie, I better be laughing.
This guy.
No, but the what you came? You said you came straight from work from fucking by LAX.
Yeah, man. I work in Inglewood, and every time, don't say it. Everybody's gonna be like, Inglewood was up to no good. And then that's when I say, yay. And then my eyes roll further back, fool. It's going to look like one of the skeletons in the store.
Well, yeah, you were tripping on the skeletons, huh?
Bro, there's too many skeletons.
I'm showing him the warehouse, and then he was all tripping on the big-ass skeletons right there. I told him, watch out, eh?
Damn,
and, hey, in the night.
I ain't messing around with that. Don't tell me. For a good thing I'm leaving before 8.
Damn, huh? In the warehouse, you think there's ghosts?
Hey, chill, fool.
You believe in ghosts?
Hey, chill. I don't want to say that. I want to believe in that or not.
It's not Halloween yet.
Man, dude, I've been La Llorona, fool. Relax.
Damn, La Llorona.
I don't want her coming for
Fools
me.
Fools always have a Llorona story about when they went to a rancho at their fucking grandpa's.
And, yeah,
and
dude.
Like, yeah, now, here's the here's in the night and we heard something. It's like, why? You guys really by a river? Who's only living by a river, dog?
You know what? The thing about La Llorona, like, why is she mad?
Why is she traveling?
She's the one that ended up drowning the two kids, and she's mad at everybody else.
I know.
About it, like, what the fuck?
Just
like,
be mad at you.
Yeah, dude. Like, you got yourself to blame tripping.
Well, didn't she say she's tripping because they made her kill her kids or some shit?
Oh, man.
No, I don't even know the Llorona story.
I don't even know the story.
Is there a story of behind La Llorona?
Like, I'll tell you a story. It's a fun fact. That I'm not even Mexican, fool. I neither even know.
No, but hey, Llorona isn't even only in Mexico. It's like everywhere.
Is it?
Yeah. You always hear people saying like it travels or something. Like we went to over here, Oaxaca, and then
it's probably like a long ass river. I'm from El Salvador. Oh, right. So I mean, I wasn't born there.
Yeah, yeah. I'm from over here.
Watch out, boss. But yeah, there's always like crazy myths and whatnot.
Do Salvadorians have myths like that?
Hell yeah, man. They got.
They have the Llorona too.
Yeah, we got La Llorona. There's a chupacabra there too.
Chupacabra. I don't know what that is, but I really think that that's something. Maybe it's not like some weird looking dog thing, but it's something.
That's what I thought. I thought it was like a weird looking dog thing that was just like, hey, dude, I'm hungry and I'm just gonna.
Well, it would suck the blood. Like
yeah.
it would leave the chivos or the cows and with no blood. So they were like, what? Wait a minute. So it was something big because that's a gang of blood, or it's something from some alien right now with all the aliens. What do you think about all the aliens right now?
Well, first of all, the chupacabra was probably part of a complete breakfast.
Yeah.
So, but aliens. Aliens been existing, dude.
No, I know, but I'm just saying, like, do you think chupacabras has something to do with, like, the aliens? Or
They probably get together. Like they probably get on a little campfire and everything. Yeah. They just be chilling. They be smoking out. He sucks the lambs dry. And the aliens, you know, they got cows. The aliens got the cows. They abduct the cows. The chupacabra has the cows.
Hey, they had that too, huh? That where they said the aliens took the cows up. There was like the farmers who were like, hey, we found her over here on this side. Something happened to her. We didn't know.
Where'd you get that accent from, son?
I don't know. That's my farmer
accent. Apparently aliens exist in every single farm. Dang. I've been believing since I watched that movie Signs. You ever remember that movie Signs?
Yeah, with the water.
Damn.
The little girl where she leaves the water everywhere.
That was kind of dumb, fool. With the water. Like, hey. Nah, but the scariest part of that movie was when
you just see the little leg come out.
No, wait, with the lady. Like, what lady?
No, the little leg. It comes out of like they're looking in the cornfield and it just comes out like.
No, fool. And like, when they're it's like a video camera and they're at the little kid's birthday party in Mexico or something.
Oh, yeah.
And then they zoom in and then the fool comes out. It's like, hey, yo, what's up? And you're like, oh,
yeah,
shit,
all those. Huh? You're just waiting.
Oh,
I seen another movie that wasn't aliens. But it's like that movie, A Quiet Place. You ever seen that?
I've seen that one.
And then everyone's all, they were like, hey, dog, do you think what's up? And you, like, you'll be watching it and you start whispering. You're like, hey, I'm going to go to the restroom right now. Pause, put on pause.
Be like, what? And then you're, and then you got to be real quiet. But then your tio ends up using, like, the bathroom at 4 a.m. And he's like, ah, tio, you messed it up. Bro, where did this subject come from? Like, what the hell?
It went from aliens.
Hello and welcome to Spooky Podcast. Igway.
Different stories.
Different stories.
Have you been on other podcasts?
I have been on some other ones.
Yeah.
I mean, to be honest with you, they've all been virtual.
Oh, yeah?
At this point, because everybody, you know, by that time when...
It's like through Zoom, huh?
Yeah, it was always through Zoom. So I actually appreciate... Actually coming here.
Yeah.
It's a crazy crowd tonight, you guys. Yeah. I didn't expect you guys to book this hall today.
Yeah.
Because there's like 2,000 people looking at me. They're all quiet as fuck.
Yeah. Just wait. So, cool. It's because we have a block, like a wall block, and it's a noise protector.
It's tripping me out. So like... I'm just waiting for the little sign that says applause, and then the answer, don't do it yet, guys. Chill.
That's for later on, guys.
Yeah, guys. Yeah, we got, you know.
What about the before we get away from the aliens? What about that fool on the news saying that they recovered aliens, or they recovered from a crash scene, like beings that weren't human like, and they're like, everyone's like, he was under oath, like what? And then you start looking into like the story, because you just hear the headline. Then you look into it and you're like, wait a minute, this some fool. He's like, I was 17 years old. You're like, look, dog. Like, he worked for the whatever now, but that happened. He seen that back in the day.
That's wild,
it's
bro.
Like, all right,
like, look, I mean, God, I don't
never
know.
Mind.
Like,
you lost me.
Look, I'm kind of diving deep in what I know.
Yeah.
Independence Day was based on a true story with Will Smith.
Yeah.
You know.
You're
always don't fool. It's not this fool. You believe anything. Hey. No wonder you believe that aliens exist.
But that was not with the Will Smith, but they did another movie about fucking aliens, and that shit was a real true story. Fire in the Sky.
That's scary.
That's a scary movie, and that's a real
story. That is
a scary
movie. Look, anybody who has ever seen Fire in the Sky, anybody who hasn't seen it, that movie is boring.
Yeah.
So, but... Well, I just fast forward to like the last 20 minutes, and it's...
Nah, it's cool. It's one of those movies where you're tripping out. If you don't have nothing to do, watch it. It's like fucking 3 hours.
Yeah, dude.
Like, damn, 3 hours? Pasa, tell me this whole story. I already know what happened.
And it's like, I don't want to see dudes cutting wood in the redwood, and you're then, like, you know, and dude, it's not...
And then
dude.
That fool, when he's up there and he's trying to squeeze out, it looks like Jim Carrey when he was coming out of the rhino.
What? Damn, that's when nature calls, fool.
Remember Ace Ventura?
Yeah, man.
No, but that's what that fool looked like when he was coming out, when they had him like in some shit. You're like, and he had all the... That, I'm telling you, that movie's fucking crazy. That was like
nació.
The back in the day crazy first alien movie that was a good one.
Oh, dude.
That was a good movie when you were like 10, 11.
Yeah, dude, that was a really good movie. Dang, I
did. E.T.
Hey, you really brought it out, dude.
Yo, damn.
Nah, E.T. was before my time, but all I know about is E.T. phone home. And then.
You never really watched E.T.?
I'm going to be real with you. Like, I have never seen E.T. all the way through. I've only seen bits and pieces.
Yeah?
Like.
You know a movie I've never seen that fools are like, everyone, like, they watch is The Goonies?
You know what? I haven't seen it either.
I've never seen
fool.
The Goonies.
I've never seen it either.
And this was, everyone's and like, you know oh, you've never seen The Goonies?
I don't care
I'm like,
that I don't see
I've
the
never
Goonies.
Seen the fucking Goonies. Or fucking Stand By Me.
Oh, no. Well, Stand By Me is actually pretty good. Right, that was pretty good.
But I never watched it. I seen fucking Stand and Deliver.
Oh, everybody, look, if you grew up Chicano, if you grew up in Latino type of people, yeah, see that fool right there with the hairnet? Yeah, I know. I see you, fool.
I'm all looking.
La raza, fool. All right. Damn, dude, this is a crazy crowd that you got over here.
Crazy crowd today. Tough crowd.
No, man, like, Stand and Deliver was that movie that they put on when the substitute was in class,
yeah,
and they didn't know what to do, and was like, here, we're gonna show you this film here, and it's a great educational, productive film to encourage all of the children here to go for your goals, go for your dreams, and never give up. But I don't want to do calculus.
Remember that?
Like, no. Like, but it's about math. I don't want to watch a story about math
with the numbers.
Yeah, dude. It's like, what the hell?
Again, what's his name? No, Edward James Olmos, Santana.
Yeah, dude.
You watched American Me?
Damn, well, it feels like an interrogation. Yo, it's like I'm being judged. Like,
did you watch?
I need your Latino card, sir. I need you to know. Wait, hold up. Wait, chill. We're going from one movie from one to the other. Okay, so American Me, I haven't seen. I only seen bits and pieces, but it's one of my brother's favorite movies. Like, yeah. He loves that movie. Then you mentioned Blood In, Blood Out, which is funny because I hadn't seen that movie for the first time, like all the way through, like maybe 3 or 4 years ago.
Yeah.
And it's crazy because it's like I've been to like East LA and like I noticed like some of these places and it's like you get really nostalgic and you're like, damn.
You're like, hey.
Yeah. It's like, hey, there's El Pino.
Yeah.
Did you say El Pito? No, El Pino.
Yeah, hey, look.
That's the pine and for the people.
Cinco Puntos is right there where that food comes, where he gets the tamales.
Dude, I want to go out there and actually want to just recreate the little scene and then he'll be just like.
I'll go with you. And we'll film it right there by El Pino.
But you got to buy me the tacos.
The tamales.
Yeah, the tamales.
If you guys go to Cinco Puntos, bomb.
Yeah, tell them.
They have carnitas. Like, you can get carnitas by the pound right there, and they give you homemade tortillas.
Hell yeah.
Like, you can buy a pound of carnitas, and then they give you homemade tortillas and a soda.
If you go to Cinco Puntos, let them know that we sent you, and they'll be like, ¿De quién hablas? And so I'm like, oh, whatever, but they sent me.
Good for you.
Beats me. So it was that, and no, since you mentioned, and I think the other cultural Latino movie in this case would be La Bamba.
La Bamba, all day.
All day.
I still cry in La Bamba.
Everybody does.
When he's all, you sure he said Richie?
Yeah.
That's the worst part, huh? You're like, oh. Yeah.
And then I gotta go. Bing, 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 bing. And then you do it
again. Wing, wing, wing. And in the picture,
no fool, you gotta yell Richie.
Oh, we did the first one. We can't waste two Richies in one podcast.
Oh my god, those.
Yeah, it could only have one, eh?
Bro, what did I sign up for?
Yeah, wait a minute, hey, when's the break? I'm leaving.
But I'm pretty sure that if you play that song is Sleepwalk by Santo y Johnny.
Yeah.
And I'm pretty sure, like, if you were, like, in the 90s, you could go up to, like, Echo Park. You could come up to any chola. If you learn that song on your guitar, yeah, that's marriage material. She'll fall in love with you like this.
I'm still with her to this day.
Damn.
Because of Santo and Johnny.
Whoa.
If you can play that on guitar, it's a rap.
It is a rap. And so that's are the like Sharpie pens that come with it for her.
You don't ever hear fools play that song. Everyone just wants to play Stairway to Heaven.
Which one?
I want to hear Stairway to Heaven.
Stairway to Heaven?
Led Zeppelin.
Oh, there's a rule that you're not supposed to play that.
Yeah, when you go to the guitar center or whatever, they're like, hey,
yeah,
no Stairway to Heaven fucking Eagles, I think. It's a...
What is it? I only know, like, Hotel California.
Yeah, Hotel California.
Really?
But I think it's that one, and I think it's that song.
That's crazy.
Because you know how fools want to go in there and stuff.
Nah, because that's how it is. You ever walk inside a guitar center, and it was like, oh, let me check out the drum section.
I know, like, I go in there like if I know how to play instruments and shit. I don't know how to play none of these shit.
I don't know. Play
the saxophone.
You go into the keyboard section.
It would have been bad. What instrument would you have played if you could play an instrument?
You know what? I do play an instrument.
Damn. What's the instrument?
I play ukulele.
Yeah?
Yeah, the only reason why I play it is because I failed that guitar.
Yeah.
Because guitar is 6 strings.
Oh,
and ukulele only has 4.
Yeah, yo.
And that
it's like a bass.
Yeah, dude, and my fingers are like gordo, dude. So it's I need to be able to have like
guitar.
Yeah, I can't stretch these sausage fingers all over a 6-fret guitar. Hell no, 6-string guitar.
And you're good at ukulele or not?
I'm all right. I'm decent. I'm not like somewhere.
Motherfuckers, get down. You know who I seen the other day that plays ukulele? I didn't see him, but I heard him, and it's on some random, that guy, Karim León,
mm-hmm.
He's like a Mexican singer. That fool played a, he was playing like a corrido song, and he played it with a little ass ukulele.
Dude,
he's like
it's cool.
In his hotel room, fucking chilling, and he's playing a ukulele. Oh, sick. Saca la yuca.
Yeah, dude. You could. The cool thing about the ukulele is like, if you learn like four different chords, you could play like maybe like 80% of the songs that you probably hear like in the radio or just like from old school.
With
there's like four different chords. Like there's a C, there's an E major, and then G, and then I don't know what other one. Maybe like a C. But anyway, but it's like you could practically play like any one of them.
Está sudando. I gotta get the fucking. It's because I'm nervous, eh?
Why are you nervous, dude? I'm the one that should be nervous. We're here in a crowd of like 2,000 people.
I'm fucking always sweating, dog. Always. I'm just hot.
Yeah.
Motherfuckers just all hot. And the worst part, I grew up in a little ass town. That shit would be like 126 degrees, like on a normal.
What, like Victorville or something?
No, past it. More up. Ridgecrest. Little ass town. You ever heard of that place?
Nice.
If you heard of Victorville, keep going a little bit more.
Then I get to Fresno and I'm
it's too hot. It's too hot. Look out. No, we're way before. We're over high desert.
Oh, damn.
We're over high here. Desert. Like, we're only like 3 hours away, but it's hot over there. Like 120 is like normal. Fools are like outside kicking it, barbecuing. You're like, dog, I'm not doing nothing.
Yeah, dude.
I went over there after a long ass time. Said a night with my homies. And then I woke up in the morning and I was like chilling. And inside his house, is like he has AC. It was cool. And he's like, yeah, we're going to go. We went outside. I went outside. I was like, what the hell? It was all bright. I was like, damn. And hot. I was like, damn, what the hell's going on right here? My homie's like, what? I'm like, fool, it's hot, fool. I'm like, and it's all bright. He's like, fool, what do you mean? He's like, what the hell? You forgot or what? I was like, nah, but damn. It's like a whole fucking different. When you're used to being out here, and then you go out there and the heat is hot.
It's fun.
And it ain't a humid hot. It's like a just straight dry hot.
Yeah, it's like Super Mario Desert level hot.
Yeah, you're like, fuck. Who fucking put what the heat on? That shit is just hot.
No, that's and even so.
Texas,
it's like,
you been to Texas?
Yeah, I've been to Texas.
I cut this fool off all sick right now, huh? Damn. Always. You know me. I'm known for cutting motherfuckers off.
That's why I have self-esteem issues, fool. That's why I can never control the conversation.
No, hey, but Texas, I fucking got off. I was in the airport. I was like, damn, feels good right here. Cool. Hell yeah, I'm about to hit Texas. I was walking out. Right when the doors open, you walk out and you're like, it's like a fucking hair dryer on you.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
And it was like midnight. I was like, it's fucking 9:00.
And it's funny because it's funny that you mentioned that and before you rudely cut me off. So anyways, no. So I was saying is that because I'm sure you grew up over there and then you kind of acclimated to the weather down here, right? Because you've been here for a while.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's like what I usually say is that when you're like here in the LA area, just for Southern California, I feel that we start complaining once it goes over 80 degrees.
Oh, it's over.
And then it's like, fuck, it's too hot. Oh, I know, mames.
Yeah.
And then once it hits below 70 and it goes to 69 degrees, I know that's your favorite number of degrees. Yeah, so chill.
69.
So relax, fool. We haven't even got there yet. And then once it gets down there, then you're like, damn, dude, it's cold. Yeah, fool.
Get the jacket. Hey, wait, hey, I'm going to go get my fucking sweater. You got to get the thermal.
No, fool, you have to go home and then you got to find the blanket with the tigre on it. And then you got to wrap yourself around.
That's tiger blanket weather?
The tiger blanket weather, fool, is coming up.
Hell, hey, it is in a couple months. It's all fucking hot right now, and then it's going to be cold. And then here come out the more complaints.
Yeah, dude.
Being too cold.
You're already getting it started with the fall. With the spooky season, with all the spooky talk, man, you gotta.
I know with the ghost, huh? Damn,
hey, no, you know what? I shouldn't even mention anything. Like,
hey,
dude.
Don't even talk. Don't say that.
We don't.
I get scared. And
fool, I ain't hard like you, fool.
Hey, what was I gonna say about your videos? From where'd you get all those fucking? Do you just like how did you do it yourself? Where you got into that shit, or someone say, hey, you should make a fucking video of some shit?
So. Obviously,
like you used to,
hey, man, the shit that you do is pretty cool. So it's like, thank you, yeah, first of all. And again, thank you for the invitation.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Basically, I got into it just because I feel that that's the most useless information that I know. Real talk. It's like it's just random shit that I just happen to know, and I just like being able to share it.
Yeah.
And the thing is that when I had first started, because it was like COVID was happening, and so it's like you couldn't really get out of the house. So a lot of the stuff that I ended up doing when I started off, it was like me waking up at 2 a.m. to, you know, the fucking Girls Gone Wild.
Yeah.
From like back in 2000s, like boom, 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 boom.
Yeah.
And then that's when you get up and you're like, oh, damn, fool. And then you go to your door in Victorville or wherever, high desert you live at, fool. You lock the door. Then you grab the toalla, the towel, and you put it under the door so that nobody could see it. This fool, like, because you're guilty, fool.
We used to do that to smoke butt so the fucking smoke wouldn't go under the door.
Damn. Hell yeah. You got to go like that, and then you just cover yourself in the blanket, and you just get ready. Damn, Skinamax, Friday after dark. Oh,
remember
dark.
The fucking channel where you would just, it would be like that?
Yeah, it would be like, all like,
you would leave it on for a while, and then you would get lucky, and it would be like, poof.
Yeah, like you'd be like,
you'd be like, oh, like, shit, oh, you look around.
I think I saw a little round spot. Like,
oh, shit, wait a minute. Is this shit supposed to be on?
Yeah, that was channel 99 for me. I never forget.
Hell yeah.
That was channel 9.
That shit was hilarious.
That's when you become like super like, like all of a sudden your eyes are like enhanced. And you're like, okay, I got superpowers. I could pretty much make out. It's like they're moving horizontally a lot.
No,
so it's like
those are the ones, and then sometimes it would just be like, and it, you could see it normal, and you'd be like, "What the?" That shit was like, wish come true.
Yeah, but little if you're
kid, I'd be like, "Oh shit, what the fuck is happening?"
If you're a real G though, back in the day, and it was, you knew somebody who worked with the cable company. And they had a black box.
The black box.
Damn. Well, I'm bringing back all of these memories. Eres un sucio, un travieso, maldito y malcriado, dude. But you're like a whole bunch of shit all black booked box, into one.
The black box would be like, my dad would be like, hey, no le pongas en estos canales.
You can't put it on channel 98.
That shit was
98.
The fucking Playboy channel, yeah, and all that other shit.
Playboy channel.
Be like, what?
That's when you start finding out that there's channels after 99 and it's like 101. I'm like, what?
What are you doing out at fucking 2 or 3 in the morning?
Yeah, dude's like, you be sneaking over there to the living room. You're like... Like, you got to put it lower. Like,
you just, turn it off.
You got to make sure you have the blanket on.
Sick ass. Yeah, dude.
You got to have the remote control. Make sure that the button on the last goes back to the Disney
You're
channel.
Like, please don't turn it on. Please don't turn on the TV right now.
Oh, man. That's embarrassing, dude.
Sick ass fool.
Yeah, man. I got caught a couple of times. That was not fun.
Fuck, oh, God, you're like, what the
fuck? Nah, dude. When I got caught once, this is a funny story. Like, I got caught, like, watching one of those things, like, back in the day. And my dad, he was like, he kind of looked very disappointed. But he kind of gave me, like, one of those, like, religious talks of, like, oh, you know what? You know, Dios, él ve todo. He sees everything. He's like, he knows exactly what you're doing at this time. And I'm like, oh, God damn. and it's just embarrassing, dude.
You're
it's
everything? Just,
yeah. And then at that point, then that's when I just learned it, just how to copy VCRs and stuff. I would just put a tape, put in 98. Put a record and go back to sleep and wake up like at 5 a.m, go back out and take it out and then just save it for later.
You'd be like, hey, they ain't home. All right, let me get my fucking routine.
I had to
cracking.
Make sure to take it out of the, out and change the channel before my dad got up for work, because he always got up like at 5 a.m. So,
hey, you're awake? Oh, I went to the restroom.
You know, my dad was awake at 5 a.m. because you hear the, because he's brushing his teeth. As always, I don't know what it is about dads, but Latino dads, at least for us, whereas they just, they're loud as hell when they brush their teeth and it's just,
hey, what the fuck? You fighting somebody in there, motherfucker? What's going on? Fucking back in the day.
So, I was
Hey, they said when you brush your teeth, you're not supposed to rinse with water.
Audience, audience, do you believe this guy?
No, I seen that shit. Some fool would say, he's like, oh yeah, when you brush your teeth, you know how you'll spit it out and then you'll rinse out, spit, and then you wipe your face. They said, no, you just spit it out, rinse of toothbrush, and then wipe your face and leave. I guess you're supposed to leave that shit because that shit that's in there, it keeps your fuck. I don't know.
I was like, fool, well, I don't know.
You do that. Don't be lying, Ethan.
Hey, you can't be asking the audience to jump on your side. That's not cool.
I know. You're Usager. But
Ethan is all the way up there, fool. Why are you asking him?
Hey,
chill. So, look. When you're, look, I could understand that. But, I mean, if you're, like, poor and stuff, then it's, like, it's not like you really have a choice.
Yeah, you don't give a fuck. I mean, learn that shit till four, what, 35.
I don't know. That's just as weird.
Yeah,
it's
too late.
This guy.
What was I gonna say?
So hold up. So let me just kind of go back to just like my own content and whatnot. Because it's like I've been telling all of these stories about me getting caught watching Channel 98 and a black box, and but. Yeah, anyways, but that's basically what I concentrate on, which is usually everything in the 90s and the 2000s, early 2000s. Because that's just me. My childhood brain remembers all of the stupid shit that happened in between those days.
Like the shit you were doing.
Yeah, because here's the thing, and this is like a little bit of real talk here, is that you see so many social media accounts that'll just post videos or they'll just post commercials and stuff like that. It's like, oh, hey, well, you know, it's like, it's nice. Like, oh, shit, yeah, I remember that, you know. But me, I don't want to be the type of person that's just posting commercials and videos, because I'm pretty sure you guys have seen them and stuff. Yeah. But I'm trying to focus on very specific moments in your childhood where this thing happened.
Yeah.
So, like, for example, with the black box. Like, you know, the very specific moment when Girls Gone Wild came up and you're like, oh, shit, I got to lock the door and all of that stuff. Like, that specific. Whereas other accounts will just post the Girls Gone Wild commercial.
Yeah.
You know? Like, oh, so it's like this? Me, I'm just very specific to a particular situation.
Like, remember how it was.
Yeah. So it's like, yeah, you remember when this happened? And it was like, whoa. And then it was like, yay. And it was like, oh, snap. So
the funny, fuck it, some of the funny ones is like when you go to a party. When you did one where you, when you get, do you go to like some party or your family has a party, and then you get there and you're like, and you look and you're like, oh, look at this motherfucker, and it's some fool getting all crazy.
Yeah, it's usually, it's like, what's funny is what I really like to integrate is I like it when, because I usually find videos of kids that are just rude as hell.
Yeah,
as you know, like. You know, it's like, cállate la pinche boca. You know, you're like, what the, like, who, like, who's recording these, you know? And it's like, eventually, so I'll insert myself in these little parties. Yeah. And then I'll be like, hey, primitos, what's going on? And then it's like, cállate tu pinche boca. I'm like, hey, what the hell, bro? Where's your tío at? And, you know, the little kid's crying. He's like, give me a taco. And he's like, yeah, I hate you, tío. I'm like, what the hell?
Yeah.
It's just those situations. Funny. Like, I can't necessarily recreate everything that happened from back in those days, but you know, you find it very relatable, so to speak. But
all those, like all the videos that you posted, I'm like, man, that shit's hilarious.
So I tried, dude.
Like my brother sends me videos of that, and my sister should be like, oh, look at this shit. Remember this? I'm like, oh shit. And then it's just like everyone relates to that.
Yeah.
Like how Mo was saying, like we relate to it, you know, 99, like the 90s, 2000.
Yeah. Because I mean, that's one thing that's super important to me. Is that not only because there's so many creators that will post stuff about either the 80s, the 90s, 2000s, you know, even the current generation right now, they're posting stuff from like stuff that happened in 2010, which is like nostalgia for them,
yeah.
You know, whatever floats your boat or whatever. But for me, it's like, it's not only just spreading the 90s and 2000s, but it's also about spreading the culture of how we grew up as Latinos, because there's a very specific memory of we as Latinos, Hispanic, whatever you want to call us, you know,
Yeah, and, it's way different.
Because I mean, that's what I can relate to specifically. Yeah. Like, you know how people freaking act whenever you put El Payaso Rodeo song at a quinceañera, then everybody goes crazy. And you know, the face that you make when you're trying to eat at a quinceañera, and then the camera guy just starts showing up out of nowhere, and you're like, what the fuck, Luke? Like, I'm trying to eat, you know?
The videos out at the quince, and everyone's all...
Yeah, and then the primitos, which are like these little silver tooth kid traviesos, like they're unhinged, dude. Like, they got no filter.
My brother's fucking wedding video, my brother had a Mac-ass wedding. I was in that shit, little ass kid, tuxedo, G'd up, thinking I was a player, trying to pop lock and shit. Little ass kid, but my brother got married at the Crystal Cathedral. Like, damn. That's a big ass wig. Yeah, and I was like, damn, back Crystal in the
Cathedral,
day. Yeah.
I only went there and once as a kid.
He had a video, and then that fool had a video before fucking, motherfucking at the beach and shit. Like, I was like, yeah, what the fuck? But the Haina that he had, the girl that he had married, her family had money.
Wait, but I know. Was she a white girl?
No, she was like a Cuban girl.
What?
Yeah, go on, I'm entendi.
Damn. But
yeah, her family, carajo. They own like a restaurants in San Francisco, like a chain of some chicken restaurants out there.
Damn.
And I don't know how my brother ended up with this girl, but they got married at the Crystal Cathedral, and I was in the video, and I was all dancing, and then you see me giving a flower to like some lady, some older girl, trying to be a little Mac. Ever since I was little, just trying to do some shit. Just be like, what's up, girl? And I'm saying, this lady was like 25 or something. I was like, you want to dance?
That's how it always is.
I'm all dancing with her. Oh, you can see me. I'm all dancing all crazy.
When you're at that age, you're like, hey, all of a sudden you got superpowers. And you're like, what is this, pop dancing? I was like, I'm able to do this, you know, for the younger generation. We're talking about Riz
right now, in a video.
The way that he's explaining himself, he was the great Wizard of Oz at this point. The Wizard of Oz.
The Riz.
Because you got that Riz at that young age, dude. When you're there, you feel hella powerful, especially when you wear the nice clothes, dude.
Dog, I was in the tuxedo.
I ain't wearing the stuff from Ross. I'm not wearing the stuff from Marshalls or anything like that. Like, I'm wearing the stuff from La Senora, the one that made my little custom tuxedo.
Oh, God.
Dude, I'm straight pimping. Poo, pop that collar.
A little Mac.
Yeah,
I remember being a little ass kid. I remember going to rehearse for the wedding, like, hey, don't mess it up, because I was one of the little kids. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't even know what I did. I didn't bring out the ring or nothing. I did something, but I had it was like me and then two other little girls. And,
I don't know. You were probably just like...
I was just one of the little kids right there. He's like, hey, throw my little brother in that shit. My brother, he's like, throw this little motherfucker in the wedding.
I feel sorry for him. So throw him in there.
Let's go. But yeah, we're in a wedding, kicking it. It was tight. I remember. But yeah, that's fucking Crystal Cathedral.
That's wild, dude, because Crystal Cathedral, I always associated it with like a higher income kind of a deal.
Yeah.
Because I've only been there once.
I'm sure it is.
I've only been there once, and I remember that was like the first time I tried, like, you know, the El Sangre del Cristo, And you're like...
Oh, yeah, where they go up and they...
Yeah, they give you the little bread, the little panecito.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, I'm tripping out because I'm like, do I go up there or anything? Or nah, because I went up there and I was like, I want to go up there because I want to try the bread.
That was when you did your first communion, huh?
Yeah, and I didn't do it. And
then I was like, what do you say when you go up there? I want one of that. One of the things they give you.
That's the funny thing, because I never had a communion or anything like
that. I never got baptized.
I was just going up there because I was like,
everyone's like, hey, here
is the body of Christ. And the blood. And I'm like, all right, cool. It sounds good. But is there really blood in the body or anything? Like,
it?
No, it's panecito y juguito. Yeah, I'm like, all right.
Yeah, so, when they give it to you, it's like a...
Yo, you know, and I was like, I had I had the I had the bread, and then the bread, it just like melts in your mouth.
Yeah, it's like, it's like a wafer.
It's like, damn, dude, I had like, these with the little vanilla wafers from the 99 cent store.
This little wafer right here, dude. And that's it.
Yeah, and then it was like, and then the juguito was grape juice. And
you
I was like,
hey, did you see the one with the little girl? And it's like wine and a little girl, and she sips the whole cup.
Yeah, I'd be down. I'd be down like that too, man. Yeah,
give me it.
Let's get hook me up with that Welch's grape.
When you're little, you used to be drinking shit fucking your nose.
Yeah.
Oh, I remember my friend had a bottle of amaretto that he took from his parents.
Uh-huh.
And we drank that shit. We were like, I don't know how, fucking like 15, 14 years old. That shit was disgusting.
Amaretto.
And I just remember fucking plugging my nose and drinking that shit.
Ugh. Speaking.
Never ever in my life will I drink amaretto again.
So, speaking of drinking, now I told you that I'm a straight edge kind of a dude. So the only beer I drink is root beer.
Yeah.
But there are some drinks that are like liqueur based that actually taste pretty good. And there's a drink that I haven't had in a long time. Do you remember this blue bottle called Hypnotic?
Yeah. I'm all, I'm fucking excited.
Yeah, see, audience, you know about Hypnotic?
Everybody. I remember Hypnotic.
Hypnotic, dude. It was a blue bottle. It was like, it looked like a genie bottle.
Yeah.
And it just tasted good. To me, it tasted good because it's like me. I'm like beer ill, and it's like, and then when it's Hypnotic, it's like, oh wow, this I feel quite sophisticated here.
Yeah, yo, let me see. It tastes like Kool-Aid. Delicious. Give me this motherfucker.
Yeah, it tastes like whole bottle. It was like Kool-Aid.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. I remember that. And then the other thing that I used to drink a lot of back in the day was Smirnoff Ice.
Oh yeah, Smirnoff. Remember?
Smirnoff Ice for me was the bomb because it was like it's soda with a little bit of alcohol.
Like a little squirt.
Yeah, so it was like it tasted like a squirt, and I was like, hey, you can't talk shit about me not drinking. I got Smirnoff Ice. But the thing is, like, you can't really go hard and be proud of that because, like, nah, look at this fool drinking Smirnoff Ice. Where's the Corona at, fool?
You have to drink like 10 of those.
But
remember,
you know,
Zimas? I never drank.
I wish I had a Zima.
I never drank Zimas, but I always heard about Zimas. That was like the back in the day beer. You tried Zima?
No,
do they still make Zima?
They brought it back in 2013, but it was available in Canada.
Yeah.
And they just phased it out. And then it's still around, but it's only around like in Japan now.
Yeah.
So it's like, but I don't even know if it even tastes like whatever that Zima used to be. Because, I mean, I was too young to have Zima.
I know, so that's why I never tried.
That's why
Zima,
I never had
I remember
it.
Zimas.
Yeah, because by the time I was like 18, like, you know, Zima was already long gone.
Remember Nog Zima?
Damn, Nog Zima.
Remember Nog Zima? They don't have that shit anymore.
No, really?
I don't think so. I haven't seen Nog Zima forever.
Nog Zima is what I used to use when
We would get a sunburn. One time I got a sunburn, my sister put that shit on my back. Fuck, that shit burned.
Bro, Nog Zima was like, I used to have like these acne. It was like a montaña. It was like when you're crossing the frontera, dude. It was straight up like a whole bunch of like granitos of, it was just, I don't know how to explain it in English, but it was just like all zitted out and everything. But I remember using Nog Zima and just going like,
yeah,
doing this like every day. When I was like 12, 13, that's when I broke out really bad.
Did it work?
Yeah, it worked.
Hell yeah.
It worked after a while.
What was the other shit?
OxyPads. The little pads that came out. And then you have to. And those are actually
OxyClean.
OxyClean. There you go. No, that's different. OxyClean is.
Oh, yeah, that's a man. But wait, there's more.
Yeah, like Billy Mays here.
Yeah, that fool. No. I know the Oxy, the clean pad.
Yeah, the Oxy pad.
And then they had some other thing that those ladies, remember, they were in like their like a doctor's suit. And then there would be, what do you call it? There would be like in a doctor's office, and it was, they had some thing for like acne.
Doctor's suit.
It was like some acne shit.
Audience?
And some ladies, they were like the people. Oh,
this is it? Was it like this blue bottle? Kind of like a green, bluish bottle?
No, it was like a white bottle.
Kind
of
like this?
No, it was like a white bottle.
There was a commercial that used to come up like all the time.
It was some shit. It was called, everyone used to
it
get
was called
that
Proactive
shit.
Solutions or something.
Yeah, Proactive.
Yeah. And
no,
like,
no, it wasn't Proactive.
No, because Puff Diddy ended up like sponsoring it and whatnot.
Dip their face in the water.
Neutrogena?
And then that was a Oxy fucking whatever.
I don't know. I just
But right now, We're going to go into a little break, guys. Let everybody know how the motherfucking wheel spins. We're wilding out, telling stories, but we're going to a little break.
Salud.
Like any success story, Suavecito started with a dream to open up a hot dog spot. We started selling our homemade Suavecito at local barbershops and car shows to the people that we knew would love it most. They demanded more, so we made more. Fast forward 12 years and millions of happy fans and friends later, we still use the same formula at an affordable price. We believe that great hair starts at the roots, our community. And nothing builds community like looking our best together. Suavecito is more than just pomade and top chef grooming products. It's who we are and who you could be. Because when you feel good about yourself, people notice. Ready to transform your hair game for good? Click the link and pick up some of our award-winning superior pomade and help us get one step closer to opening that hot dog spot. Suavecito. Get it, hombre.
Bam! And we're back, just like that. Thank you guys for tuning in with us, checking out Suavecito. Make sure you guys go to suavecito.com, get everything you need to look right.
You know what I'm saying? If you want to look hella firme, you make sure that you grab that Suavecito.
Grab the Suavecito. When I started using Suavecito, before Suavecito, all my fades were 0 to a 3. Zero to a three fades all the time. And then I was like, man, I always want my hair to stick back, dog. And that fool AJ, he's like, grow it out, fool, who cares? Put fucking Suavecito in it. And I fucking started putting Suavecito in it, and that was the only thing that would make my hair slick back. And because my hair is curly, like straight fro. Uh-huh. And it's the only thing that would make my hair slick back. So I was like, that's it. Ever since then, everyone knows Suavecito. The fools at work call me Suavecito.
This guy, what about the la señoras? Not las señoritas, not
Tomasito.
Oh my God. You gotta let me know what Doña Marta calls you.
That's my mom's name. What? Hey, how do you know Doña Marta? That's my mom.
Thanks. Hey. Yeah.
No, but yeah, that was it. Suavecito in my hair. That was the only thing that slicks my hair back. And anybody of my homies that wear hair, they slick their hair back or whatever, Suavecito only.
You know what? Real talk, like, even like, because I usually keep my hair short.
Yeah.
But when there's times when it grows out too much, yeah, it literally grows like a fro.
Yeah.
But it's spiky, but yeah, it's like a cactus afro. So it's a cat fro.
Yeah.
So what I tend to do is I hate using gel because yeah, it makes it like all hard and yeah, it makes it like all weird and stuff. But yeah, but then in that case, I put the Suavecito on.
Oh shit, I'm about to grow it out.
I put the Suavecito on, and then it's like, all right, cool. I can probably pull this off.
They're going to call you the slick back.
Slick back.
No, homie, slick back's coming right.
Oh, no.
Don't trip. You ever seen that? When fools, they slick their hair back as fuck?
Nah, when they see me, it's going to be slick back, baby back ribs.
Yeah, damn. Slick back, baby.
Because where we're going to go eat, baby?
Damn, huh?
Chili.
Baby back ribs are so bomb.
What?
We went to Memphis and tried the original ribs.
Oh, I was about to say, I'm like, you went to Memphis and we went to Chili's, fool. Why would you go eat ribs at Chili's in Memphis, fool?
Imagine, y'all, fool, I went to the Chili's in Memphis.
Dang.
No, but we went to Memphis, bomb is barbecue. The ribs, like, you know how the ribs have like a little cartilage or something? Like a little... You don't even notice that right there on those. You're just
giving
that shit.
All you see is just one bone. You're like,
what happened
to
the cartilage? We don't know.
Yeah.
Shit, we just ate that. I'm telling you. Hey, but one thing about Memphis, they're a little racist.
And welcome to the podcast, everybody.
No, but for real, we went to go eat to the barbecue spot, and it was like raining. And the lady, she's all looking at us, and then she's all, you guys sure you don't want to sit outside? And we're like, do you not see this shit raining right now? Like, no, we don't want to sit outside. And yeah, I don't know.
Yeah,
like, I mean, the security was right with us when we were eating.
Were there umbrellas outside, like, at least, or anything? On? Or
nothing. That's why. It was just tables. And we're like, why would we sit outside?
Why would we sit outside?
That's why. They didn't want to sit there. And then when we went inside to eat, the security was right there.
And when I said that I wanted
my... And I just told the homie, hey, dog, just think we're famous. Dang. And this is our bodyguard right here. Nothing can happen to us.
When
just
I said that eating. I wanted my ribs wet, I didn't mean it like that. I wanted wet with barbecue sauce. Like, what
dog,
the
it
heck?
Was messed up. But other than that, it was cool.
Speaking of messed up, were you the type of kid, because, you know, you go to Memphis and you go to Chili's to baby back ribs, but I bet you do the same shit when you go to St. Louis as well. St. Louis ribs.
St. Louis. Never been to St. Louis. I went to Texas. Fucking ate mad barbecue. I went there, ate barbecue. I was like, give me the fucking mixed plate because I want everything. And I ate everything, and all I did was just go to sleep on fucking in the car.
Damn. Fool,
got the itis. He done came to Texas and got the itis.
Oh, man.
Give it up to my homie Grunt out there that took us on a tour, showed us everything. And then in Dallas, they have like drag races. Like there's a place called Yellow Belly.
Uh-huh.
And they have drag races. Like you go there and you watch the races. But on certain days, like anybody could go there and race their cars. And you see like youngsters with like their dad's car or their aunt's Cadillac. Just the most random cars, like just a regular car. Like, I'm gonna go there and race, dog.
So it's not
and
made
fools
up.
Bet money. Fools are like, oh, 200 on a Buick right now. And they're like, all right, go. And it's like some regular car, and they go at it. And fools make money right there. And fools be, they'll fight. You see fools fighting in the crowd, you're like, hey. It's like, well, this fool bet and he lost. He thought he was gonna win, didn't wanna give up the money. Come here, punk. Texas don't play.
Only in Texas, yo.
So don't mess with Texas.
Yeah, apparently.
No, but Texas is tight. I love Texas. I love Dallas, all that, all, everywhere out there.
One of my best friends live in Texas.
Yeah, it's a bomb. And then my homie, they go to the actual, you know, like street outlaws. You know how where they do the drag races, like on the freeway or in the middle of nowhere? He goes to the real ones. Like real, he's right there, and it's like these fools actually set up in the middle of fucking nowhere, and they race, and sometimes a who doesn't come and break it up, or they don't even know because it's so out in the boonies, and they set up real drag races out there like street outlaws, but Texas, like, the real shit. Badass cars.
All I really know is Fast and Furious kind of racing when that comes to that kind of stuff.
When drag racing
like I'm not that, talking about like Fast and Furious 8, 9, 10.
What about the fucking mamalonas?
Huh?
The mamalonas.
The mamalonas.
The trucks. The fools are racing the trucks. And they do fucking donuts in the fucking middle of the fucking street.
Oh, dude, I hate those.
The street takeovers? You be like, I'm trying to go to a fucking store right now, dog.
I'm trying to go to 7-Eleven. I'm trying to go to Top Value. I'm trying to go to Northgate Market.
You fools block the whole street off, and these fools are doing donuts. And then if you try to cut them off, you're getting jumped. Don't try to stop a fucking street takeover. You see, some man got beat up by 18 teenagers.
And sir, fucking, where were you trying to go? I was trying to go to Northgate. I'm like, what the hell?
So hey, dog, it's bad.
Man, I just remember, like...
They'll shut down the freeway.
Yeah, but I mean, it's like, you kind of wish that it was like, at least me, where it was like an age of Honda Civics that were all jacked up.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Yeah, I don't know, probably like your girl's Nissan Altima. That's
with the
all
wing. Fools had the ground effects. Remember the ground effects?
The ground effects.
I remember we had... my mom bought a Cougar, like a 1990 Cougar, a Mercury Cougar. It was like the drug dealerist car in the world. It had like a vinyl top, and then the whole bottom had like ground effects, like to make it look like it was low. It was just like, I was like, Mom, why'd you buy that? She's like, no, me gusta. And it was like a straight drug dealer ass car. I was like, where did you find this car at? And it was just, that was the shit. Remember the 90s when fools would do, there would be like a Thunderbird or some other car, and they would, in the hood, it would be a drawing of fucking Gloria Trevi with an AK. You never seen that?
Bro.
Or the trucks on the truck in the back.
They I would wasn't have like, really, look, I'm real talk. Like, I did, like, I'm feel so clued out of this whole conversation.
Yo,
the only
happening?
Thing I remember from cars back in the 90s is drive-bys happening every Saturday and Sunday.
Hey,
so
drive-bys were a hit.
I was not trying to hang out outside like after 9 p.m. because shit was going down.
But you don't remember those trucks? And in the
I mean,
back,
I remember
they had the mural
Trevi,
of that
I,
truck going like up.
Everybody
up
had a mural
hill.
Of the Aztec lady that's dying in the hands of the Aztec warrior.
The
that's what
truck.
I would do.
Or the
that,
trucks on the side, they would have the bull. Like the big ass bullhead on the side of the door on the truck.
Bullhead? What the heck?
Remember?
No, dude.
And you're like, where are you, dog, when you see me?
Where is this? And because you grew up in the valley, fool, you're in the high desert. This is where they have these cars.
No, when you're here in LA. Like fucking Compton, Paramount, all that shit.
Like, do you remember the ones with the Laugh Now, Cry Later?
Oh, hell
with
yeah.
With the sad face and the happy face clown theater mask or whatever?
Hey, you want to hear a story about me?
Hold on. And then before the Mamalona, because we're talking about Mamalonas, and then you have the little kid that's pissing on whatever car logo.
The No Fear?
Not the No Fear.
No, but it was like the kid from the No Fear, and he'll be pissing on a Chevy sign.
Yeah, you just put whatever on there. Like, you could put...
The decals.
You could put the decals. You could put Chevy... Yeah. Toyota, put, you know, decal your swagger or whatever, dude.
No, now the decal is their fucking Instagram. Like, oh, fucking holding it down. Nostalgic,
you know what?
At Nostalgic Latino on the back of your
There's
fucking...
people that will put their socials on their car.
Nah.
And it's so stupid.
Why?
Because there was this one chick, she ended up cutting me off. And she has her little thing where it's like 818. Beauty queen nails.
You're whatever. Okay, bitch. Let me hit you up on the fucking gram.
No, you're like, you drive fucking stupid. Don't watch your driving.
Learn how to drive.
Yeah, learn how to drive. And you
what
know.
About the worst?
She left it on red, and then I got blocked.
What about when you be driving by a car and they'll say like, cute blondie, or I'll say sexy Latina or something. You'll be like, wait up, let me see this. What's going on in the car? And there'll be some...
And then you're like, hey, bitch,
are you borrowing the car right now?
Nah, dude, that's how they get you. And then it's like, all of a sudden you find out they're selling Herbalife and all of that stuff to you.
Remember Herbalife?
It's still around, fool.
Hey, I always trip out on fools that sell Herbalife, and I'm like...
You think you trip?
Why, dog?
I trip. Because it's like some señora, I'm just minding my business, and the señora just shows up out of nowhere. Hola, mijito, ¿cómo estás? Te miras bien fino. Todo. Tú sabes qué, pero I can help you. I'm like, oh, wait, what are you talking about? I'm like, okay. I'm like, mira, toma mi tarjeta, take my card.
Yeah.
And I'm like, okay, Herbalife.
Yeah.
Doña Marta. Yeah. Or whatever, you know? And it's like... You know, no, it's like, I thought that she was genuinely concerned about whatever, maybe my health, maybe my good being, maybe just wanted to ask me how my day was.
Nah,
she just wants me to join the pyramid scheme.
Trying to make that pyramid.
Yeah.
I heard about my homie who posts videos of him, and he's like, look, a month later, and he's the same. Now who's all flexing, all crazy on Facebook? I'm like, hey, did you get hacked? And he's like, nah,
fool.
Get with the program, homie. Yeah. We're doing Herbalife.
Yeah,
I'm like,
yeah. You know what? They're like, oh, damn, it works. Yeah, it works. But I'm like $2,000 like out of the bank.
Yeah, like, yeah.
No, dude.
Does that? Has there ever been Herbalife you know how they put the results? I don't ever see result videos of foods with Herbalife. Like, where you're like, oh,
yeah,
look at
this
food.
What you mean.
The new one is Golo, right? I always see that shit on TV right now.
Golo. What the hell is Golo?
Some shit. They're like, oh, you know what? I lost 60
Let's
pounds
not
of
give
fucking
them free
Golo.
Advertisement. This podcast is not sponsored or to support Herbalife materials.
From early 2000 shit, that fool fucking, hey, what are you doing with your life? You ain't doing nothing with your life
hey,
right now.
Hey, I did a video about that. What are you doing there sitting on the couch?
Yeah.
I see your lazy ass on the couch. What
ain't
are you doing?
Nothing.
Pick up the phone right now.
Call DeVry.
Do something with your life.
Yeah. Like, what is DeVry? Like,
there's classes ready for you right now. We even have night classes for you when you get out of work.
Yeah.
You got no excuses. Look at yourself.
And then later on.
What are you waiting for?
Then a chick comes on fucking an hour later. What are you doing with your life?
Oh, man.
Doing the high nuts all. You're like,
that's horrible, dude.
That was one of the commercials from back in the day.
Yeah.
Or fucking.
I remember that would usually end up showing up right in between watching like if I was sick from school, like you're watching The Price is Right in the morning.
Yeah.
And then it was like Jerry Springer, Maury,
Montel.
Montel Williams, Ricky
Montel
Lake,
Williams all day.
Jenny Jones,
Ricky Lake.
And then, anyways, but right in between any
Sally
of those.
Jesse.
Damn.
Remember with the lady with the
she
glasses?
Had the red glasses.
She kind of looked like Miss Doubtfire, huh? If you think about her now.
That's kind of like an insult to her.
What
no?
happened to her?
I mean, she's probably still around.
Jerry Springer died, dog.
I know, dude.
Fuck.
Man, too bad you don't watch my videos.
Mayor. I talked about that on there.
You gotta watch my video, dude. I made an awesome Jerry Springer video. Yeah, he's like, hey, let me invite this fool to the podcast. He sounds kind of funny. Have you seen his video? No.
No,
but that fool's funny.
What about Jerry Springer when he had like the Runaways on the show? Remember the from Hollywood? Like all these kids that ran away and they were like punk rock. And then he had like some kids that ran away and shit. And they're like, what happened? And he's like, I don't fucking want to be out of my house. Little ass kids.
I mean, that's Jerry how they Springer. All are. Every time that you see one of those talk shows, it's like, but before we bring Laura out, let's see what she has to say. And then it's like a black and white, like, I'm a bad bitch and I don't listen to nobody. Nobody tells me what to do. You know, I'm drinking this and I don't even care. I'll even drink it at school.
Yeah. And then it's like, bring her out.
And all right, okay. All right, now bring out Laura.
That was like, remember the Mexican version of Jerry Springer?
Bienvenidos a José Luis Sin Censura.
Remember when they were fighting?
You know, that's where a lot of popular stuff came out from. That's where Jack in the Box girl's from. She goes, Jack the Box, hell yeah. Jack of the Crack, hell yeah. I love that That's chick. That she's cool.
Oh,
I mean, she's probably missing in action. But
fools would go right there to fight.
I know.
I think they paid them.
No, they didn't pay them. It was just free. It was just free because they, you know, hey, you could go for free showing. It was cool. Because a lot of that was scripted. And they would just fight and they would just grab people from like from the streets. Like they would pay them to go in to get down. But in terms of the audience was down.
They were just fools like, I'm going to go over there and I'm just going to rust a fool on the stage.
Yeah, it's like you see all of these full bald headed fools and they got the Raiders jerseys on. Yeah, and I don't know if I should be part of this show.
Yeah.
And it's crazy because it's like they just, you know, okay, tienes una pregunta para él.
And then they were just rushing.
All of a sudden, no more Spanish. It's like, hey, yo, I think you ugly fool. Step up. Where you from? And then they just go down and then they start fighting out of nowhere.
You're like, what was their crossing?
It got so bad they ended up creating a fence. They ended up putting a little fence for it, right?
They put
come on, fool, a fence is nothing to some cholos, especially the chain link fence. They're used to just jumping that shit. It's either a brick wall or the fence. Cholos will just jump over it. No problem. But then afterwards, then they added like a little like a trench or like a little moat Right in front of the fence. So that way, if you needed to hop over the fence, you needed to jump down.
We're not going.
And they ended up doing that. And I was like, nah, man, this is too much.
That was a downhill.
Yeah, then they hired, I think, a little more security. But yeah, those are the good days.
Remember that fool, Osito?
Osito.
Remember the fool who would be on there? He was the one that would take fools out. He was a big ass. That fool was like 7 foot. Big ass fool. He would just pick up fools and just take them out. And if fools would be still swinging, he would just be picking them out and take them off the stage. Hey, that shit was some wild shit. Yeah. Huh?
So let me just give a disclaimer for people that are watching. They're like, I don't understand. What is José Luis without Sin Censura? Basically, we're talking about the Spanish version of Jerry Springer, and Osito is a big security guard. He's like the equivalent of Steve from Jerry Springer. So he was just, and it was wild because it was very local, and people just got on there just to get down.
What about the camera man on Maury?
Man,
that fool would, when the girls would be like,
oh, they
would
be like, hey, Jerry, you're not
the,
for that.
You're not the father. The girl would be like, fuck. And you would just book it.
Like, let's get ready. Let's get ready. You already know that he got the Cortezes or the Nikes that are on ready to. Okay.
They
ran really quick, dude. Hey,
Maury would have some ghetto shows too, though. You'd be like, oh, this fool right here, fucking, he's dating Michelle and he's sleeping with Michelle's brother and mother. You're like, what the fuck? More, get your ass over here on fucking Jerry Springer. Hey, they have the most get, and then all the ones with the, if you're the father, you think that shit's real too?
Yeah, I think that's legit.
That was real, huh?
I'm pretty sure that's legit. It's as real as you.
People on there.
Yeah, it's as real as you coming back home and asking your mom to cook a caldo during the summer when she shouldn't be doing that.
Oh, it's already done.
Nah, because that's not cool.
Oh, you want menudo in this 100-degree weather?
Let's go. See, that's what happens when you grow up in a high desert area, dude. You like that shit.
Fucking caldo de res. You didn't have an option in Ridgecrest. It was always hot.
Chiles, hot and windy. It was 110 degrees outside.
In the desert, it was just hot and windy. It was so windy, you would go outside and you could fucking lay like down on your side, on your back, and the fucking wind would hold you up. Windy.
Like the wind would hold you up. I'd
be like, the house is going to flip over right now.
Damn, it was like that.
It'd be windy, dog. You would open the door and it would just be brown dirt flying, just fucking a dust storm. You're like, what the fuck is going on? Is this normal? Dog, I'm telling you.
All of a sudden, the desert music starts playing every time you open the door.
Cowboy starts coming out with the movie.
And then you hear some guy goes, welcome to the Sahara.
Yeah, you ain't been here before.
No. Welcome to victory.
Ridgecrest.
Welcome to Ridgecrest.
Now we're past Victorville.
Past Victorville. Yeah, but we are going. Not, we're not above Fresno.
Yeah, I'm telling you. Hey, no, sometimes it snowed over there.
And then a guy pulls out a carpet and is like, I have these wares ready for you. Hey, please choose one.
You want to hear some crazy shit about the desert?
Take this for your journey in the desert. In Ridgecrest.
The guy, the cowboy?
What are you talking about? I'm talking about like some random dude that's just welcoming you to the desert like they do in the movies.
Some cowboy dude.
Yeah, and then a camel comes out of nowhere.
But out there, my homie, he does tattoos on like these like military-ass men out there. And they'll be drunk and they'll be getting tattooed and they start telling them stories. And they said that there's like a portal out there, like from the mountain to like this, the China Lake, the actual lake. And that's why it's all blocked off right there. They're like the bases. They're like a lot of shit where there's portals and shit. There's always like a base around places where there's like crazy phenomenon or whatever, like portals type shit. Or
I think you've been watching too many X-Files.
No, this is real shit. Like my homie actually tattoos these people, and they tell him this. And he's like, dog, he was telling me about there's fucking a portal from the mountain down to like the China Lake. And that's why they made a base there and shut off that whole area. Like the military, they actually own that land, all that, because of the portal. Real shit.
Conspiracy theories brought to you by Suavecito Pomade.
Now here on the Conspiracy Hour. Some random X-Files shit. Out there in the desert, there's so many crazy videos of like UFOs and... Everyone has a story about seeing shit like that out there.
Tommy, and three places weird.
Ya está pegando la cerveza.
Nah, me, I would be scared. I would be like, a la madre, a la madre, a la madre, a la madre,
there was always weird. There was weirdos. In my old town, there was a man that we called him Looney.
I don't want to hear about him.
I never knew his real name. We just knew his name was Looney.
Damn.
Like, and one time he was fucking walking down our neighborhood with a big ass 357 gun, all fucking in his underwear. At like 2 a.m, and my dad's all, ya metanse. Fucking, everyone was like, hey, what the fuck's going on? This fucking weird ass man was just walking down the street, and I'm pretty sure he's killed people before. They called him Looney. I don't know why they called him Looney.
Bro, I'm trying to make this podcast really funny, but you keep on coming back to some spooky shit like all the time. Name it Looney. Look, I'm a swing it. I'm a go off on a little tangent because you said Looney because you named him Looney.
No, everyone named him Looney.
You remember your favorite reggaeton group, Looney Tunes?
No, remember fucking Daddy Yankee?
Yeah, everybody knows Daddy Yankee. Daddy Yankee. You're asking me like if I remember. Well, everybody knows Daddy Yankee.
What was the lady's name that did fucking reggaeton?
I don't know if there's been a lady
something
that
Ivy or something. No,
quién?
The famous lady. Reggaeton, the king of reggaeton, always is Daddy Yankee. Because whenever you think about Daddy Yankee, who do you think about?
I think of Gasolina.
Exactly. Daddy Yankee.
Dame más Gasolina. You know, real talk, with reggaeton, I used to be really annoyed after. Because I was like, I would always tell myself, every single song always sounds the same.
Yeah.
Because it's like... Like, you just gotta wait for it. Like, 5 seconds in, like, and then all you gotta do is just
start
bopping.
Damn, should we try to? Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to start a group right now, and I'm saying everybody get ready for the new album that's coming out
2024. Yeah. I'm ya mero.
Yeah, I'm about to be right there. Ya mero.
Ya mero, fool.
Hey, what about I was talking about fucking reggaeton. But what music do you listen to?
I listen to everything. You know what? I hated Bad Bunny for a while.
And now you bump that shit.
I bump that shit
now. You're like, what? Wait a minute. Okay. Yeah. Is it like after listening to it so much?
Or it was really bad the whole time. And then it kind of like his songs kind of became like of a meme a little bit.
Yeah.
And then I started finding it funny. And then so I would listen to it because it was funny. Yeah. And then Un Verano Sin Ti comes out in the summer, which practically saved everybody at that point. And
you're like, okay.
And it was being overused. And then I was like, you know what? I actually kind of like it. It's not that bad. Yeah. And then at this point, it's like, oh, yeah, I like Bad Bunny. It's not that bad.
What's like the top three that you listen to right now? Like in your car, when you're driving home from work?
Like in terms of
music,
like music in general.
What do you listen to?
Ooh, that's hard. I never get tired of listening to Tears for Fears. Everybody Wants to Rule the World.
Yeah,
you're like, yeah.
Come on,
what
you don't mean it right now,
man.
Oh yeah.
Everybody wants to rule the world. Yeah, see, like there's that one.
Tell me the name, I don't know it, but if you show me the tune, I'll be like, I'll fuck with it.
I'm like a freaking like play whatever song you want to, sir.
What is it?
Yeah. I like listening to I listen to a lot of old shit still. Like I listen to MJ.
Yeah,
not Michael Jordan, fool. Relax. I'm talking about Michael Jackson. Yeah.
Oh, Michael Jackson's a motherfucking
beast. Yeah, I never get tired of Michael Jackson. I listen to The Weeknd a lot.
Yeah.
I like The Weeknd probably because he sounds like Michael Jackson.
Hey, you think he does?
I think he does.
A lot of people were like, "Hey, this motherfucker sounds like Michael Jackson ripoff," but he's good. Yo, hey, wait a minute. No, he's good though. He's good. He's killing it. He even has a show, The Weeknd. But on some weird like shit, I'm like, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, he does have a show.
Yeah. Then I'll listen to like Bad Bunny every once in a while if I feel like bumping into something. I listened to a lot of punk from like I don't even know. It was like pop punk, like Blink 182, Weezer.
Weezer did a cool we're not Weezer, Sum 41. But that fool that sings for Weezer, what's his name?
Rivers Cuomo.
Rivers Cuomo, they have that one song, they covered the Beach Boys song, "Don't Worry Baby."
Yeah. Oh, I love the Beach Boys too.
All right. They did a cool cover of
Beach Boys.
Listen to Rivers Cuomo to what do you call it? That song, "Don't Worry Baby." That's the guy from Weezer.
Don't worry, baby. Yeah.
It's just like all chill, and they kind of play like in a circle, like a fucking choir or some shit.
Yeah, dude, we should all get like a big old choir. We should do our own little thing.
Let's do it. We'll make some shit happen. Music all day.
Music all day. Brought to you by Suavecito Pomade. La música.
What's your
top? That's like a producer tag. Actually,
what's your top five favorite movies? From back in the day that you always watch.
Oh, or now. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Part 2. The original one with the live action.
Part 2?
Yeah. I like watching Fast and Furious Tokyo Drift. I heard we somebody have in the audience.
Fast and Furious stuff.
I know, fool.
Get a little shirt real quick.
Damn, you gotta chill. It's like what else? I like The Mummy, The Mummy series.
The Mummy Returns with Brendan Fraser?
The Mummy, I like all of them, anything within that series. So The Mummy Returns, Dragon Emperor is okay. I like The Sandlot.
Sandlot, old school movie. Nobody fucks. Nobody talks about the Sandlot, huh?
They do talk about the Sandlot.
No, but I'm saying like they don't ever add it to their top five. That's a dope ass movie to watch.
The Sandlot is really good. Oh man, I'm trying to.
There's so much badass movies, huh?
So many, dude.
Well, I'll watch all the movies.
Oh, I love Rumble in the Bronx with Jackie Chan.
Damn,
that one I never get tired of.
Rumble in the Bronx.
That was my first Jackie Chan movie ever.
Hey, that fool does all his own stunts, huh?
I know, but that fool's getting kind of old, so he can't do them anymore. So he has other people do it. I haven't
seen a Jackie Chan movie in a long time.
Because he's older. He can't do them anymore.
Does he still fuck around? But you know what? You ever seen Jackie Chan, The Drunken Master?
Yep.
Hey, that fool is like sick.
That fool, yeah, as soon as I had watched Rumble in the Bronx, I was like, okay, let me check out all of his other stuff. And I was like, holy shit, this guy worked for Bruce Lee and really all of this stuff and whatever. And it was pretty wild. So with that being said, it was like, that was like, I think that was like his first mainstream American movie too.
Yeah?
Yeah, so it was like.
Rumble in the Bronx? Which one? Is that the old, like, it's like in a. Back in the day, it's not
'90s. No, it is '90s.
It is.
It's '90s. He goes to New York and he's like, "Uncle, I'm here." And he's like, "Oh, how are you, Jackie? Thank you for coming." It's the English dub for it is really funny.
Yeah,
he's like, "Oh yeah," it's like, "Oh, hello, Jackie. Hey, let me tell you, I just got married today."
Oh, it's
you
like got that?
Married, Uncle? And it's like, "Oh yeah." So
I'm gonna watch that. I'm gonna go really home cool. and watch Rumble in the Bronx tonight.
And it's really Jackie Chan's voice, and he sounds awesome.
I'm gonna tell my kids they like whatever, like they like karate shit, dinosaur shit.
They even dub the people that are actually speaking English. It's really weird.
You're like, hey, we know what their fools are saying.
It's like get him, and it's like, I was like, you know,
the guys are.
I don't want no trouble. Get him. Like, Jackie Chan's over here. I'm just minding my business. Get him!
They do the blood in, blood out version in Spanish, and everyone's all, watch that movie. But I'm like, I can't get into it. Like, it's just, they dub everything. Like, how you say, even the Spanish parts. I'm just like, I can't get into it.
You know what movie's actually pretty funny in Spanish dubbed is the movie Friday.
Friday?
Yeah.
I seen a little bit. He's all, ¿quién es este?
Yeah. So those are really good. There's so many movies, dude. That I'm probably gonna get killed because like I can't believe you haven't mentioned Friday or you haven't mentioned.
Everyone's always like, you should have done that. One thing I wanted to ask you was, you know how you do all those videos? Do you have fools and homies that are like, hey dog, you should do a video of this and do it, and you're like, hey.
That's always really weird because I don't want to insult anybody.
Yeah.
Because it's like. It's like people, it's like you're preaching to the choir here. It's like, yeah, I've kind of done this. And it's like, and it's just, it's kind of weird. It's like,
always have the good ideas, huh?
Yeah, it's like, hey, fool, you got to do this. And then you got to talk about waking up to this and this. I'm like, well, I mean, I kind of covered it like a while back. I mean, I could show you the old video. I mean, I could probably redo it again or repost it.
Yeah.
But it's really cool, though, because... one thing that's kind of humbling and it's also really nice and very endearing is when I say fools, I'm talking about like these fools that are like they look straight up hard, like they wear Suavecito and they're hella firme, you know? So it's like they go, I was at a CVS in East LA, in like Lincoln Heights. And I'm just waiting in line. Hey, fool. I'm like, oh, hey, I know you from somewhere. You probably see me in something. I was like, you're that funny fool. Yeah, I like your videos, fool. They're funny as shit. And then I'm like, oh shit. He got the baggy white shirt and he got the flannel shorts.
That's it.
And
white ass shoes.
He got the high socks. Nah, he wasn't wearing the shoes. He was wearing like these fuzzy slippers kind of thing. I don't know what they are.
Yeah, the corduroy hat shoes.
Yeah. So I was like, yeah, those. Yeah. Those what they are. Yeah. And he had his glasses and he had, you know, short hair. And I was like, oh damn. It's like Yeah, it's like it's reaching out there.
Yeah.
It's just really cool because I could be at a CVS and a fool noticed me there. I was at Panda Express earlier today and they're like, oh shit, you're that fool that makes the videos. I'm like, yeah, that's cool.
That's cool, huh? When people tell you what's up.
Yeah. I would prefer people to actually come up to me and be like, hey, yo, what's up or whatever. Like, I'm not saying that I'm like, hey, yo, I'm A-list celebrity Carlos. So it's like people will recognize me and it's better that they come up to me and they say what's up, because there's times when fools will be like, oh shit, and then they grab their phone and they're going like this, I was at a convention and some fool was like, he was videotaping me. I didn't know, my friend told me, and I was like, oh yeah, I think they're filming you. I'm like, what the fuck? I'm like, what? And then I looked at him and they're like this, and they're trying to be slick and they're like this. You know, like they hold their phone up like this, right? Like,
what are you doing
right now? And then I'm like, and then, you know, and I don't want to make it feel awkward because it's kind of weird. And I don't want, and I'm not the type of person to be like, hey, you, put down your phone. Like, that's not me. Hell no. Yeah. You don't think of the huevos para eso, man. Hell no. I don't like confronting people. But but in response to that, I just kind of did my little bob from La Bamba. I'm like, and I just kind of covered my face, pretending like I was hiding, like Beverly Hills Ninja, El Gordito. And then I'm like, and then at that point, I'm like, ah, fool, you got me. Like, nah, fool, if you come up to me, just say what's up.
Yeah.
You don't got to film me from afar.
You see, fools are like, oh shit. Fools looking at you, like, is this who's not mad at me? Or what the
sometimes,
fuck?
And sometimes it comes across like they just look at you and then they start laughing. And then it's like, are they laughing because they know me? Or is it because of the way I walk and I walk funny?
What's happening?
Yeah, so it's like it's a preference if they were to actually stop me and just be like, hey, yo, what's up? I'm like any other person. Like, even here on this podcast, even when I'm talking to you, I'm talking to these guys, you know, the producers, and even the 100 people that are in the audience. 2,500. Chili. Humble yourself. Humble yourself. Well, we're not at SoFi Stadium yet. We're not at SoFi Stadium. We're in the Santa Ana Playhouse right now. So
make sure to check us out at SoFi Stadium 2024.
Suavecito
Fest. We have Carlos right here hosting.
So yeah, so it's I'm just like when I tell everybody, it's like I'm just another dude on the other side of the phone. Yeah. And I'm just as chill. I'm not like, oh no, please do not talk to me, you filthy peon peasant. No, if you wish to talk to me or have me on a podcast, talk to my manager.
Yeah,
you know, that's not me. It's just I usually handle most of the stuff on my own.
Yeah. Well, and then fools are like, oh, what do you guys do? You ever had like a fucking office or something? And you're like, dog.
Yeah, it's like, I'm like, whoa, you have this many followers. Right? I thought you would have a team to handle this. I'm like, no, I'm just kind of here.
Yeah,
I'm just chilling in bed eating my Funyuns.
You are just kicking it.
I'm just kicking it.
Hell yeah. But thank you for coming on our show, telling your stories. Do you have any shout outs that you want to let people know what's up?
Hola, ma. Everybody in El Salvador, los quiero mucho. And then shout out to Don Francisco from Salvador Gigante. I miss you. I'm looking forward to seeing Luis Miguel in September. So, Luis, me, if you see this, te quiero.
Oh, he's watching. He's actually a fan.
I believe you.
Yeah.
I believe you. He's a suavesote.
Luis me.
He's not a suavecito. He's a suavesote,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, we call him Luis me over here. He's one of the homies.
Yeah. But, nah, on the real, like, I don't really have anything to plug. I just appreciate everybody who's watching me. And I appreciate everybody who reaches out, throwing messages, showing love. I have just as much love for them as well. I got love for you guys, love to the producers, love to all of the 2,500 people that are in here. Yeah! Because when you put the laugh track on and the audience track and whatever. And then, and I'm glad, I'm blessed that I'm here, that I have an audience, and you know, I get invited to these things. It's very, I'm grateful that I'm able to have these opportunities open up and be able to do these things. So thank you very much for inviting me. Thank you guys for being very hospitable. And
thank you for taking your time coming out here and letting the people know what's up. We're gonna have all the information where you can link with Carlos down here in the bottom. Make sure to check us out. Thank you to Suavecito, Cerveza Cito Brewery, 4th Street and Broadway. Make sure you guys go over there for a good time. Thank you for everybody that watches. And we're out.